Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello students, I welcome you to this lecture on problem number 2 of series RLC circuits. We have seen problem number 1 in very detail, including all 3 cases. Now in problem number 2, we will see some kind of mixture of all what we have learned till now. So let us see what that problem exactly it is. So here you can see that they are saying determine whether following RLC series circuit is underdamped or it is overdamped or critically damped, and also find VL of 0 plus and I of infinity. Now by common sense that I of infinity for RLC series circuits should tend to 0, except if it is the case of oscillating one. For example, for RLC series circuits, these are the only 4 cases which are possible, out of which case number 1 is, we all know, conjugate and imaginary roots. Here you get sinusoidal response. In case 2, 3 and 4, you can see your response tends to 0. So let us first check, depending on the value of zeta, let us first check which kind of response it is. So we all know that formula for zeta is nothing but r by 2 into root of c by l. Now r is given 200 ohms, c is 10 microfarads, l means inductance is 0.1 henry. So I'll put here 200 ohms divided by 2 into root of c divided by l. So 10 microfarads divided by 0.1 henry. Henry means 10 to the power minus. So when we solve this, here I will get 100, and here I will get this 10 to the power minus, when we will go upstairs, it will become plus 1, then it becomes 10 square, and minus 6 plus 2 is minus 4, and the whole answer for this term will be 10 to the power minus 2, and so your answer will become 1. So it doesn't seem to be, but your zeta is 1, and from this table, when this zeta is 1, you will get negative real and equal roots, and that is the case of critical damping. So you can see it here, negative real and equal roots when zeta is 1. And we have got zeta equal to 1, because this is 100, this is 10 to the power minus 2, and so critical damping. So first answer we have got, so it is critically damped. Now they are saying also find VL of 0 plus. So now we will find VL of 0 plus. So for that we need to write initial conditions. So first we will write what are the conditions at 0 minus. First answer is done. So second one is about initial conditions. And for initial conditions, well, there is something called as u of t here. Now what we know, u of t is unit step signal, and u of t is a signal something like this. So at time t equal to 0 onwards, and this is nothing but time t greater than 0, it is equal to 1, and here it is equal to 0, 0 value. So that means at time t equal to 0 minus, this voltage is 0, and when this voltage is itself is 0, then definitely here inductor, which is short circuit, because at time, we all know that at t equal to 0 minus, inductor is short circuit and capacitor is open circuit. But this itself, this voltage is 0, because u of t is a unit step signal, which is of this way, or this, this is how it is actually written. And so at time t equal to 0 minus, definitely this inductor current, no voltage, so inductor is going to act as short circuit. So the voltage across inductor VL of 0 minus, we'll write it as VL at 0 minus equal to 0 volts, as well as you can see capacitor will act as open circuit, and again the voltage across capacitor is going to be 0 volts. So this voltage, you can write it as VC. This VC at 0 minus is also 0 volts. Well, now this is about initial conditions. Now we'll see what happens at t equal to 0 plus. Now at t equal to 0 plus, this unit step signal will come in picture, and when it is at t equal to 0 plus, inductor will act as open circuit and capacitor will act as short circuit. So we will write it, inductor is open circuit and capacitor is a short circuit. So during that time, if we redraw the circuit, this is open circuit of inductor. So we can write this as VL of 0 plus, and for capacitor it is going to be a short circuit. Well, (200 × U(t). And this is nothing but I of 0 plus, which you can easily say that it is 0 ampere. Well, what will be the value of VL of 0 plus? Surely it is going to be exactly equal to 200 × U(t). Now 200 × U(t), it is nothing but 200 × 1 volts, that is equal to 200 volts. So the same voltage will appear here as this is short circuit. So VL at 0 plus is nothing but going to be 200 volts. That is our required second answer. So this is answer number 2. Now let's go back to the answer number 3. And the question says that find I of infinity. Now because this is a series RLC circuit, we are bound to get second order differential equation, and whose solution will be given by roots, mainly S1 and S2, which we are familiar with. So we should write the second order differential equation, or directly we can write the roots. But before that, what we will do, we will find the value of zeta, and that value I think already we have found, and zeta is 1, that means it's a case of critical damping. And in the case of critical damping, we know that our roots are negative real and they are repeated. So this is actually from this table which already I showed you. So when zeta is 1, you have negative real and equal roots, and that is the case of critical damping, and this is the graph of it. So the roots are minus of omega n. Now how minus of omega n? That is quite clear from this, that as zeta, you can see here, as zeta is equal to 1, 1 square will be 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So here it is just minus 1 into omega n. So minus of omega n. So roots are minus of omega n and minus of omega n, where omega n is equal to 1 upon root of LC, and the value of L and C, which we can find from this given chart or given diagram, that L is 0.1 Henry. So it is 1 upon root of 0.1 meaning 10 raised to minus 1. And C value is 10 microfarads. So it is 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. So if we solve this, we'll get root 1 upon root of, this is 10 to the power 1 will get cancelled with this. This and this will get cancelled. 10 to the power minus 6 under root. So write it here as minus 6. So it's going to be 1 upon 10 to the power 6 by 2, so it is minus 3, or it is 10 to the power 3, you can write radians per second. So this is 10 to the power 3 or 1000 radians per second, and well, the roots are minus omega n, so you write roots are minus of omega n, that is equal to minus of 10 to the power 3. But we know that whenever we have negative, real and repeated roots, the standard solution for this case is nothing but I of t is equal to k1 plus k2t into e raised to power st. So in this case, because this is the standard solution for repeated roots, so I of t will become equal to k1 plus k2 into t into e raised to power st. So this is nothing but equal to s. Both are s, s1 and s2 are called as s here, and it is minus 1000 t. So e raised to minus 1000 t is going to be my answer. But this is my general solution. This is not my particular solution. This is called as general solution. For because we have to get I of infinity, which is actually we can get from here only. Because when you put t equal to infinity, this term, well, let's check it out. We have to put limit t tends to infinity. This term will tend to 0 and first term also will tend to 0. So there is no need to solve it further, by the way. So this there is first term, term number 1 is k1 e raised to minus 1000 t. And you see, this is nothing but, let us say I1 of t. Let us say that this first term is I1 of t, and at t equal to, when t tends to infinity, when you take limit t tending to infinity, you will get this I1 of infinity equal to 0, because e raised to minus infinity will be 0, and so your answer will tend to 0. Well, you can surely get k1 and k2 constants, but that will not be required here. And you can see, if you take the second term, I2 of t, I consider this as second term, that is nothing but k2 into t into e raised to minus 1000 t, that is nothing but k2 into t upon e raised to minus 1000 t. And when you take limit, when you put I of infinity, I have to put limit t tends to infinity k2, and it is of, you can use L'Hospital's rule, and when you put that formula here, this is nothing but t upon e raised to minus 1000 t. This answer will tend to 0, because as t increases, well, this term goes, denominator it becomes plus. So here also it will become plus. So as this t increases, this t will also increase, and both the terms will increase, and they might cancel each other. You can see, when you put this limit, you will get answer equal to 0. We can verify this by taking the, or by calculating the constants k1 and k2, but we will get the same answer. See, now if we want to know what is the initial current, because if you want to get k1 and k2, you will need I of 0, how much? And that I of 0 is what, nothing, already we already got it. If you see at t equal to 0 plus, and this current I of 0 plus was equal to 0 ampere. So this is nothing but equal to 0 ampere. So I will substitute this value here. Let us say this is equation 1. And when you do it here, I will get I of 0, which is equal to 0, which is equal to k1 plus k2 into 0 into 1. So that gives me k1 is equal to 0. So this k1 is 0. So I will reduce my equation first. So if I substitute k1 0 here, I will get I of t equal to k2 into t into e raised to minus 1000 t. Now we'll take differentiation of this. So di by dt, that is equal to k2 into t into minus 1000 into e raised to minus 1000 t. I'm using UV rule, plus e raised to minus 1000 t into 1, and that gives me k2 e raised to minus 1000 t. Then here it is minus 1000 into t plus 1, because I have taken this e raised to minus 1000 t common outside, and this is my di by dt. Now what is di by dt at 0 plus? That is, I need to find out just to verify it. So for that, I will require to draw what happens at time t greater than 0. So let us go back to the original circuit. So for this, you will see what happens at t greater than 0. So at t greater than 0, our circuit will be something like this. 200 into u of t. Then I have a resistance of 200 ohms. Then inductance of 0.1 henry. And then we have a capacitance of 10 microfarads. And the current is I of t. Well, at t greater than 0, if you write the equation by using KVL, what we will get is 200, because this is u of t is 1, minus 200 into I. Well, let's recheck it. It is 200, it's correct. 200 and 200, 0.1, 10 microfarads. Then minus L, that is 0.1, into di by dt, and minus voltage across capacitor, it is going to be 1 by C integration of I dt equal to 0. Now we are interested in finding di by dt at time t equal to 0 plus. So at 0 plus, because it's a general equation, we'll apply it at t equal to 0 plus. What we'll get, 200 minus I of 0 plus, this second term will become 0, because I of 0 plus is already we have written to be equal to, I of 0 plus is 0 amperes. So if I substitute here at t equal to 0 plus, it is I of 0 plus, it is 0, minus 0.1 into di by dt at 0 plus, minus, this is nothing but voltage across capacitor, and at time t equal to 0, it is 0. And so now if you solve it, this term will go to right side. So 0.1 di by dt is equal to 200. We're cross checking it. This is correct. 200 minus 200 i, minus 0.1 di by dt minus 1 by c. So this is 0, this is also 0. And this is absolutely correct. So di by dt at 0 plus is nothing but 200 divided by 0.1. That comes to be 2000 amperes per second. We have an equation for di by dt. Now what we will do, we will apply this equation, this one. We will apply this equation at t equal to 0 plus. So let's give name. Let's say it is equation 1. And applying equation 1 to t equal to 0 plus. So I will get di by dt at 0 plus. And that is nothing but equal to time t equal to 0. So this will become 0, it will become 0 plus 1 means 1, and e raised to 0 is 1. So right side will become simply k2, and this di by dt at 0 plus is nothing but 2000. So, well, we cannot write amperes per second, so that is not correct. It is just leave it as 2000 because it's a constant. So we cannot write any unit. Well, so k2 is 2000 is what we have got. And now we will substitute this into the into this equation. So substitute in equation number 2. Here we will substitute the value of k2 as 2000. I will get I of t is equal to 2000 into t multiplied by e raised to minus 1000 t. Now this is I of t, but we need I of infinity. Now by inspection only we can see if you put t equal to infinity, again you will have to put limit here and you will get answer equal to 0. So when you put I of infinity, you have to put limit t tending to infinity, and then it is going to be 2000 into t divided by e raised to minus 1000 t, and this will give you answer equal to 0. And as I told you, this is the case of critical damping. So in critical damping case, this is the graph, and you can see the graph tends to 0, the current value tends to 0. So obviously it makes sense that your total current, whatever current at time t equal to infinity, will tend to 0. So thus we have verified this from all aspects, and this numerical is thus completed. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.